Good morning and welcome to Coffee with Pastor. This is, are you ready for this? September the 13th of 2024. Good morning to you, and I trust you're having a wonderful, wonderful morning. And even though it is the 13th, I trust that you're going to have a wonderful day. Isn't it glorious not being superstitious? Anyway, let's turn our attention to our point to ponder, and this one comes to us by way of Corrie Ten Boom. And she says this: we never know how God will answer our prayers, but we can expect that he will get us involved in his plan for the answer. I like that. We never know how God will answer our prayers. We can expect that he will get us involved in his plan with the answer. And we will leave that with you, and I trust you will indeed contemplate that truth. As we open up the Word of God, I should have mentioned a little bit earlier, we are in Job chapter 9, the book of Job, and chapter 9. I trust that you open up your copy of the Word of God and follow along with us. It makes it a little bit easier to meditate on it, makes it a little bit easier to keep these things in mind. It is about 9 o'clock. So we're going to go ahead and bow our heads, bow our hearts before our Heavenly Father. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We praise you for this beautiful, beautiful day that you've given to us. Father, as we come into your presence, we again ask your blessing upon all things, upon the day. And Lord, we pray that you would bring into our lives the things that we need. Sometimes it's blessing. Sometimes it's just the average day and the normal occurrences of events. Sometimes we need to be challenged. Sometimes we need to be tried. But Father, whatever it is that you deem is best, it's to that end that we pray. Father, as we come into your presence, we do ask your blessing upon your people, each and every one of us. Lord, you have already blessed us by promising to meet our needs, by promising never to leave us, never to forsake us. You have blessed us by constantly being sufficient for all of our needs, for guaranteeing us that there would be nothing that comes into our lives that we, through your strength, cannot take. Father, today, manifest these blessings to us. Help us to see. Give us eyes to see and hearts to praise in all of these areas. And again, Lord, as we ask for your blessing, you already know what the day holds. You know where we'll be. You know what we'll be doing. And so, Father, please, that we would be faithful, that we would be pleasing to your sight, that you would look upon us and smile. And Father, may we glorify the one who gave himself for us. Your will be done. Lord, we open up your word this morning. And Lord, again, we ask that you would open our eyes, that your Spirit would teach us what we stand in need of learning. So, Father, again, we ask for your blessing. We ask for your guidance. We ask these things in Christ's blessed and holy name. Amen. And so we turn our attention to the Word of God. Job chapter 9. Then Job answered and said, I know, it is so much so of a truth, but how should a man be just with God? If he will contend with him, he cannot answer him one of a thousand. He is wise in heart and mighty in strength. Who hath hardened himself against him and hath prospered? Which removeth the mountains, and they know not, which overturneth them in his anger, which shaketh the earth out of her place, and the pillars thereof tremble, which commandeth the sun, and it riseth not, and sealeth up the stars, which alone spreadeth out the heavens, and treadeth upon the waves of the sea, which maketh Arcturus, and Orion, and Pleiades, and the chambers of the south, which doeth great things past finding out, yea, and wonders without number. Lo, he goeth by me, and I see him not. He passeth on also, but I perceive him not. Behold, he taketh away. Who can hinder? Who will say unto him, what doest thou? If God will not withdraw his anger, the proud helpers do stoop under him. How much less shall I answer him, and choose out my words to reason with him? Whom, though I were righteous, yet would I not answer, but I would make supplication to my judge. If I had called and he had answered me, yet would I not believe that he had hearkened unto my voice. For he breaketh me with a tempest, and multiplieth my wounds without cause. He will not suffer me to take my breath, but filleth me with bitterness. If I speak of strength, lo, he is strong. And if of judgment, who shall set me a time to plead? If I justify myself, mine own mouth shall condemn me. If I say I am perfect, it shall also prove me perverse. Though I were perfect, yet would I not know my soul. I would despise my life. This one thing, therefore, I said, he destroyeth the perfect and the wicked. If the scourge slay suddenly, he will laugh at the trial of the innocent. The earth is given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where? And who is he? Now my days are swifter than a post. They flee away, they see no good. They are passed away as the swift ships, as the eagle that hasteth to the prey. If I say I will forget my complaint, I will leave off my heaviness and comfort myself. I am afraid of all my sorrows. I know that thou wilt not hold me innocent. If I be wicked, why then labor I in vain? If I wash myself with snow water and make my hands never so clean, yet shalt thou plunge me in the ditch, and mine own clothes shall abhor me. For he is not man as I am, that I should answer him, and we should come together in judgment. Neither is there any daysman betwixt us that might lay his hand upon us both. Let him take his rod away from me, and let not his fear terrify me. Then would I speak, and not fear him. But it is not so with me. And may God add his blessing to the reading of his word. Job appeals to, refers to God's wisdom, his righteousness, his judgment, his strength. And in them all, he is not man like we are. And even if we think we are righteous, yet before him, we are as unclean. Beloved, all the more our dependence upon the cleansing blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. In our minds, there's no way we can comprehend or even premises the holiness of our God. How just and righteous and perfect He is, and He being our standard, we can never measure up. But beloved, it is required of us, having been washed by the blood of the Lamb, it is required in us that we be faithful in all things, to do His will, regardless of the cost. Today, strive to be faithful. Don't worry about tomorrow. Don't worry about yesterday. Be faithful today. Do not allow yourself to become, or for someone else to use you as their excuse for turning away from the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And again, please remember, you are loved by us, and yes, more importantly, by the Almighty God. Beloved, have a glorious day, and until tomorrow, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen.